Namaste students, welcome to statistics class. Now today, in today's class, we start a new chapter, that is analysis of univariate data. Till now we discussed about the first chapter, that is introduction part of statistics. That was, we have seen some of the introduction and some of the basic concepts. Then we move towards the organization of data. In that chapter we studied how to collect the data and how many kinds of data we have in front of us and which are the different measures to collect the various kinds of data. Then there was a third chapter called classification and tabulation. There we studied whatever data we collected, how we need to classify. When we speak about classification, there we classify according to their common characteristics. After classification, we have seen there how to present the classified data in the form of table, that we call as tabulation. After completing classification and tabulation, the third chapter, we move towards the graphical or diagrammatic presentation of the data. In that particular chapter, whatever data we classified, how to present the tabulated form in the form of graph, how to present the tabulated information in the form of graph. Then we have seen how to draw diagrams as well as graph over there. Then after completing that, we directly move towards the, we skip two chapters there, fifth and sixth chapter. The fifth chapter is analysis of univariate data and sixth is analysis of bivariate data. We skip those chapters and we move towards the association of attributes. Since there were no much connection between these two chapters and the association of attributes, that was independent chapter, so we have taken association of attributes. There we have seen what are the relationship between when two attributes are given to us. Is there any relationship? If it is there, which kind of relationship? Positive or negative or no association? Then after that we move towards the interpolation and extrapolation. Yesterday's class we completed the topic called interpolation and extrapolation. Now after completing interpolation and extrapolation, that is 8th chapter, now we are coming back towards the 5th chapter which we skipped over there, that was analysis of univariate data. Now when we speak about univariate data, what is univariate data? Univariate data is a single data. Single data is called as univariate data, that is where here we analyze a single variable. When we analyze single variable, we call it as univariate data. Single variable means the variable may be the weight, only one variable. Then, or it can be height, any such kind of variable. We know that what is variable? Variable is quantitative characteristics which vary from unit to unit. Quantitative characteristics means it's a characteristics of a person which we measure in terms of number, which we measure in quantitative means which we present in the form of numbers. For example, height of a person, there will be a group of people, the height of this group of people. We know that height of the group of people, it varies from person to person. So analysis of single variable. Variable is nothing but it's a quantitative characteristics which vary from unit to unit. That is, we can take it as weight. It's a characteristics of a person. But we know that it will not be same for all the individual. It vary from person to person. As well as the height. It's also vary from person to person. Or the marks. Marks scored by a group of people or a marks of a student. It also vary from person to person. So this kind of information if we take and if we apply any of the formulas there, then we call it as it's a univariate data. Univariate data means only one variable we take, either weight, either height or some other variables. Where we analyze, when our analysis is based on only one particular variable, that we call it as analysis of univariate data. Now when we speak about analysis of univariate data, and when we speak about analysis, there are different measures to analyze this univariate data, and this univariate data is characterized by various kinds of measures. So which are those measures? Those those measures are actually, which measures I will write here. So based on that, we divide this particular chapter as the different unit. So first measure here comes, that is measures of central tendency. Measures of central tendency or averages. We call it as measures of central tendency or as averages. This is the first measure. Then second one, the measures of dispersion. Measures of dispersion, where we see what are the variations. Measures of dispersion is nothing but the variation between the variables. That is second one. Then the third one, measures of skewness. Measures of skewness. This we also call it as asymmetric. Then last one, measures of kurtosis. This we also call it as peak index. This we also call it as the peak index of the curve or else peak index of the variable. So there are mainly four kinds of measures. That is, first one, measures of central tendency or averages. The second one, measures of dispersion or variation. We check the variations of the variable. Then measures of skewness, that is asymmetric. What is asymmetric? Asymmetric is nothing but which is not equal. Symmetric means it is equal. Asymmetric means which are not equal. And measures of kurtosis is called as the peak index, where we check the peak index of the variable. So these are the four measures which comes under analysis of univariate data. And in case of univariate data, when we divide it into the four measures, now under this fourth measure, this particular measures, we divide it, we make it under the base of, these are, we call it as different units of measurement. These we call it as different units of measurement. So now firstly we'll study only about the measures of central tendency. So this particular topic we call it as, we study as a one particular unit. Then later we move towards the second unit here, measures of dispersion. Then third unit, measures of skewness. And the last unit, measures of kurtosis. So all together in this particular chapter, that is analysis of univariate data, there are four units. So now we'll move towards the first unit, that is measures of central tendency. Now when we speak about the measures of central tendency or averages, we know that averages or central tendency is nothing but where the main object of the averages, that is when a large group of series will be there in front of us. For example, I take the marks of number of students. We have marks of number of students, or else we'll say marks of students in a particular subject in one college, in a college A. The marks of students in college B. There are two colleges are there. Now we need to compare between the two colleges. Now we have here the variety of the series, the set of the series of marks we have here, and here also we have series of marks. When we have this series of marks, the bunch of marks, we know that it is difficult to compare with this mark, the one mark, and with the other student. Here also one student with other students. We know that it is difficult to calculate. It might be the marks of one particular college in a one subject. We'll take stat. Here also we'll take it is stat. We have number of students here, and it is their marks. And here also they have scored marks as what we have. These are the marks of the students. So what happens here, when we have a group of series in front of us, we know that it is difficult to compare. So in such condition, we take the averages. We take the averages. How to take the averages? Averages are nothing but the total divided by number of person. Here also the total divided by number of person. So when we take the averages, for example, here we consider as average as it is, we got as 60. Here average the marks scored by a student in this particular subject, the group of student in this particular subject is 60. Here average they have scored it is 80. The group of students, their average in particular subject, the number of students they scored, their average in the particular statistics average is 80. In this college the statistics average is 60. So when we present a series of data in a single value, it is easy to compare. Now it is easy to compare. We can say that comparatively the college B performance is better than college A's performance. So there may be variety of reasons. Here the teaching may be good, the teaching method which they have chosen, it may be effective than this. So when we present a series of information in a single value, it is easy to compare. So what do we call this? This is the averages. How to take averages? Averages are the total divided by number of students. So what is the total divided by number of students? So that is the way of taking averages. So measures of central tendency, the mainly for the purpose of to facilitate easy comparison. It provides comparison easy and it makes us to present the series of entire mass of data in a individual value, in a single value. So these are the objective of measures of central tendency or averages. So what do you mean by measures of central tendency or averages? It is a single value which represents the mass of data. It is a single data that represents the entire mass of the data. It is a single value which represents the entire mass of data. Entire mass of data. So this we call it as measures of central tendency or averages. Now when we speak about averages, here possible questions are, what do you mean by averages? Averages for measures of central tendency, it's a single value which represents the entire mass of data. What are any new objectives or the requirement or essentials of averages? What do you say? The objectives are one, which it facilitates comparison, it makes comparison easy, and which it presents the data in a single value. These two are the objectives or the requirement or essentials for 2-mark question you can write. Now when we speak about averages, there are different types of averages are available. There comes the types of averages. When we write the types of averages, there are different types of averages. And these, you all are aware of these averages. There comes the first one, arithmetic mean. First one, arithmetic mean. Then comes the median. Median. Then comes the mode. Next one comes the mode. Then the fourth one, that is geometric mean. Geometric mean. Then fifth one comes the harmonic mean. Harmonic mean. So there are 5 kinds of averages are there. These all together, these all are, we call it as averages. But here the arithmetic mean, median and mode, we call it as a mathematical averages. These are mathematical average, and arithmetic mean, geometric mean and harmonic mean, these are mathematical averages. And here median and these two are positional averages. These two are positional averages. So we have five kinds of averages here. We have five kinds of averages here. Those are arithmetic mean, median, mode, geometric mean, and harmonic mean. And here arithmetic mean, geometric mean, and harmonic mean we call it as mathematical averages. And the median and mode we call it as positional averages. So these are the types of averages. Now in these five types, we take the first one, that is arithmetic mean or mean. We take first one arithmetic mean. When we speak of arithmetic mean, when we speak about the arithmetic mean, we know that what is arithmetic mean. Arithmetic mean is in a simple language, arithmetic mean is nothing but averages. But this arithmetic mean further divided into two types. There comes the first one, the simple arithmetic mean. Simple arithmetic mean. And second one, weighted arithmetic mean. So there are, in case of arithmetic mean, further divided into simple arithmetic mean and weighted arithmetic mean. What is the difference between simple and weighted arithmetic mean? The simple arithmetic mean, where we calculate averages by giving equal importance to all the items. By giving equal importance to all the items, it is nothing but the total divided by how many number of series. Total divided by, for example, the total of particular sum. Here we get sigma x as 100. How many number of observation? 10. So this we call it as arithmetic, simple arithmetic mean, where we give equal importance to all the series. Arithmetic mean is the average, where in case of arithmetic mean, where we calculate our average by giving equal importance to all the items or all the data. And weighted arithmetic mean is the average, where we calculate average by giving or by assigning weights to the values according to their relative importance. By assigning weights to the series of data according to their relative importance. For example, if I want to give example, now we know that if we go to shop, there if we ask for rice, there will be different quality of rice will be there. So some quality they will grade it as, it's a first grade, it's a second grade, and third grade. It's based on their quality. So here what happens, they are not giving equal importance. They are based on their quality, they are assigning the weights. These are weights, the first grade, the second grade, third grade. So such kind of where we calculate average, in such case we call it as that is a weighted arithmetic mean. There we call it as weighted arithmetic mean, where we assign weights according to their relative importance. So there are two kinds of arithmetic means are there, and under simple arithmetic mean there are some formulas, and under weighted arithmetic mean there are some formulas. So we'll see which are those formulas. Now I'll write down the formulas and you need to take it down in your points book, all these formulas, and you have to be thorough with those formulas. We know that we have taken the measures of central tendency. In case of measures of central tendency, that we call it as averages. In case of averages, there are five kinds of averages, that is arithmetic mean, median, mode, geometric mean, and harmonic mean. And where we have taken the first one, that is arithmetic mean. In case of arithmetic mean, as I said, there are two kinds of arithmetic mean. What first one, it is the simple arithmetic mean and weighted arithmetic mean. Now we are writing the formulas based on simple arithmetic mean, which are the different kinds of formulas are there. Now here, mainly when we speak about simple arithmetic mean, here first comes, we divide the data into the grouped and ungrouped data. What is that group when we call it as data, as ungrouped data, for example, the marks they have given. We have taken the marks 70, 80, 56, 86, 96. See, only marks. These are ungrouped data. And grouped data means what? Marks and number of students they have given. 6, 7, 8, 9, 3, 2. This kind of data we call it as grouped data, where X as well as frequencies are given. Variable and frequencies, if we have such kind of data, we call it as it's a grouped data, where in a problem where we do not get any of the frequencies, only variable, that we call it as ungrouped data. So here when we provide formula, we provide formula based on two circumstances. When your data is in the ungrouped form, what is the formula? When your data is in the ungrouped form, now for ungrouped data, we have two formulas. One is the direct method. Direct method arithmetic mean formula goes like x bar is equal to sigma x by n. Sigma x is total of this divided by n. How many number of cells? Divided by 5. So that is direct method. And deviation method formula in case of ungrouped data. In case of ungrouped data, there comes x bar is equal to a plus sigma u by n. So what is u here? Where u is equal to x minus a, and we know that when a is assumed value, one particular value we need to take as assumed value, then we need to find out the u, then we need to find out the what is the u in the particular series. Now this is about ungrouped data. Now next comes the grouped data. What is the formula for grouped data? Now as I said, when we present, when only variable will be given, that we consider as ungrouped data, and when we get the frequencies, we call it as grouped data. That means 8, 9, 10, 3, 2, this we call it as grouped data. But in case of grouped data, there are further two methods, that is the discrete data. What is discrete data? Discrete data where class intervals are not given. See, this is in the form of the discrete grouped data. This is the discrete grouped data. When you get the problem in the form of discrete grouped data, what is the formula? Here formula you get as, in case of direct method, where we get frequencies here, that is nothing but we can write it as number of students, where we get formula like x bar is equal to sigma fx by n. Then the deviation method. Method x bar is equal to a plus sigma f u divided by n. What will come here additionally? F, frequency. Where, see here, where we know that f is equal to frequencies. And what is the difference between the small letter n and the capital letter n? Capital letter n is a total number of frequencies. It's a total number of frequencies. Then what is small letter n? It's the number of observation. N is number of observations. So once again, a is assumed value, what we have take what I have given here, and u is x minus a. Once again here I will write a is assumed value and u is x minus a. So this is about group data. In that, in case of group, what is, well, these three data will be given. Now in case of group, the second one, the continuous data, when you get continuous data, what is the formula? In case of continuous, what is continuous data? Continuous data means, for example, here 10 to 20, 22, 30, 32, 40, 42, 50, 52, 60. These we call it as continuous data. In case of group, one was discrete where class intervals were not there. One more is continuous where class interval is considered. So when you get problem in the form of group continuous, what is the formula? There comes the direct method, once again similar to direct method here, that is x bar is equal to sigma fx by n. No difference between the direct method formula in case of discrete as well as continuous. And deviation method here, deviation method, that is x bar is equal to a plus sigma f mu divided by n into c. Addition is into c will be added here. C is nothing but the width or gap what we have in case of in between the class interval. So here additionally we will get the c, that is the width. C is width of the class intervals. Then rest of the things remains similar. A is assumed value and u is x minus a. What we have taken, u is x minus a divided by c will come, since we have class intervals. Then a is nothing but as it is assumed y. So these are the formulas of simple arithmetic mean. If we speak about weighted arithmetic mean, there is only one formula under weighted arithmetic mean. Now, firstly, once we revise here, I started with here the measures of central tendency. As I said, this particular chapter divided into four units, that is measures of central tendency or averages, measures of dispersion, measures of skewness, and last one, measures of kurtosis. Now we started with measures of central tendency, and there the averages are divided into five types, that is mean, median, mode, geometric mean and harmonic mean. And there we have taken the first one, arithmetic mean. Arithmetic mean is further divided into simple arithmetic mean and weighted arithmetic mean. Now here these are the formulas under simple arithmetic mean. Then mainly you will get the two kinds of problems, that is ungrouped, where frequency will not be given, and one more is group. In case of group, whether it is discrete, means where class intervals are not considered, and continuous, where class intervals are considered. And the direct and deviation formula, direct and deviation. You have many formulas here, but don't worry. At the end, at least you should remember that this particular formula, sigma fx by n, and also if it is ungrouped, sigma x by n. It is not necessary that you need to go with deviation method. You can solve, if they do not mention in the problem, you can solve the problems by using this simple formula. At least you remember here this particular formula, sigma fx by n and sigma x by n. But these are the formulas which you have according to your textbook. Now there is one more formula I will give. In case of weighted arithmetic mean, there you have only one particular formula. I hope you have taken down all these formulas. That is the second method in case of simple arithmetic mean. W, that is very rare. So sigma W X divided by sigma W. So here weight W is equal to weight. W is equal to weight. In case of weighted arithmetic, you have only one formula, that is sigma W X divided by W. I have told that simple arithmetic is the mean or average, where we calculate average by giving equal importance to all the items. But in case of weighted arithmetic mean, we calculate average by giving weights according to their relative importance. So this is the difference between weighted and simple arithmetic mean. So here remember this particular formula and this one, and one more I have told, sigma x by z. But if you are able to study all these formulas, it is better to utilize all these formulas. It's easy to calculate. Now we'll see the further. There are some merits and demerits of arithmetic mean, and then we can put what's the problems. That